I don't think you can regulate AI. How can you regulate something that's a billion times smarter than you? You can regulate humans using AI. A great example of that is your government should issue a decree immediately that criminalizes using fake videos without declaring that they're created by AI. This is an important move, because then basically, you know, you may not prevent people from actually putting deep fakes on the internet, but those deep fakes now are liable. You know, they actually now have the ability, you have the ability to tell them, you know, this is criminal. You're lying to people. And those sorts of regulations are key. They are regulations of how will AI be used. If you lay off, you know, some governments may choose to do this, others may not. But if you lay off 70% of your workforce and replace them with AI, do you have to pay a slightly different tax structure as a company so that we can, you know, reskill and re-employ or compensate for those, you know, citizens that might actually sit unemployed. So social security, I think, is one of the key topics here. And social security will go into two directions. One is jobs, of course, and compensation. But the other, interestingly, is human connection. And I know this sounds really crazy, because is it really the responsibility of a government to ensure that its humans are connecting with humans and not machines? My answer is yes, because it becomes existential. Because if you look at my generation, my dad, my late dad, which I loved very much, could not operate a video, a VCR machine. When he wanted to play a VCR machine, he would call me and say, Habibi, just, you know, put the tape correctly and press the right button. I am very comfortable with, you know, computers and screens and so on. They, our kids, are completely comfortable talking to a machine. As a matter of fact, on average, the Gen Z will talk to a machine more than they talk to a human. Now, when you really think about this, you're taking, and that machine is based where? Outside your country. So you're taking that human connection that is the core of what a nation is, and you're handing that over to a machine. So my biggest recommendation to close out my conversation here is start to work on generating your own bubble of human connection. Because in a world where intelligence is a utility, understand this, huh? What is happening now is that we're outsourcing intelligence as a utility, a plug in the wall. Today, I sit in front of an AI and I'm suddenly 10 IQ points smarter because the AI helped me. In the future, I might become, as I said, 4x smarter, and then you can quote me on the tree that has the iPhones on it. But the trick here is, can I actually, when in a world where there is enough abundant intelligence, can I capitalize on what matters most? And what matters most is human capital and humans' ability to connect to each other. And perhaps it's not entirely a government responsibility, but perhaps creating an environment for that would make a very big difference.